tributes that have been laid by members of the public who have been visiting today and yesterday. It comes very shortly after the Prince of Wales issued a statement about his grandmother, in which he said that the world had lost an extraordinary leader. So much will be said in the days ahead about the meaning of her historic reign. I, however, he said, have lost a grandmother, and where I will grieve her loss, I also feel incredibly grateful. And there he is with the Princess of Wales now, reading the messages left by people at the gates to Windsor. The Prince in his statement went on to say, my wife has had 20 years of her guidance and support. My three children have got to spend holidays with her and create memories that will last their whole lives. And indeed, there is the two princes and their wives before the flowers, a remarkable image. And let me bring in our correspondent, Fatima Manji, who is there. Fatima.
She's talking, guys. We're about to go there.
Yes, Krish, this is an extraordinary moment of unity. We see the four of them together. We were expecting the Prince and Princess of Wales, William and Kate, to come out from those gates at Windsor to come and look at the flowers. We were not expecting Harry and Meghan to be with them. And this really is a moment because it's an olive branch. We know there has been a rift in the royal family. We all saw the Oprah interview. We know what happened between Meghan and Harry and the royal family. Yesterday, the King spoke of his love for Harry and Meghan, as well as his support that he would receive from the Prince and Princess of Wales. Well, today, you can see that olive branch in action. The four of them have come out together. The Prince and Princess of Wales walking together, Harry and Meghan holding hands walking together. They're looking at the flowers, they're taking some time to read the messages. And really, this is a symbol, after the Queen's passing, that perhaps that rift, that conflict in the royal family may now be about to heal, and this is a family about to come together. And in a way, this is a successful moment for King Charles, because one of his biggest challenges within his family and for the institution of the monarchy was going to be about the Harry and Meghan issue and what happens. So really here, the fact that the four of them have come out together in this very visible symbol of unity is quite telling. And William released that statement earlier talking about how much he will miss his granny. That is certainly true for Harry too. You have got here two princes who ultimately have lost their grandmother first and foremost, and that's something that I think the crowd very much appreciate here. They cheered massively when the four of them came out, and I think there's a lot of love and respect being shown from the crowd here. However, there will be challenges in the future, undoubtedly. The fact that Prince William has been made the Prince of Wales straight away by his father, the King, is unusual. It was back in 1969 that the Queen conducted an investiture of the Prince of Wales in a grand ceremony, and that wasn't without controversy. Some Welsh nationalists do object to that. They believe that the Prince of Wales should be someone who is Welsh and not someone who comes from the English King. So there are going to be moments of controversy in the future, but for now, we have this extraordinary moment of healing, of coming together, and a symbol of unity. Krish.
Yes, Fatima, stay with us, because these images of these four individuals are truly remarkable after such a difficult period for the relationship between these two couples. And as you say, it is something that really springs from Prince Charles's address to the nation, where he spoke of his love for Harry and Meghan as they build a life overseas. And here we see them all just reading the tributes given by the members of the public. And I wonder whether they're going to go over and greet members of the public now and talk to them.
I think that is definitely going to happen. They're breaking out in applause at the moment. The public are really enjoying this moment. They're breaking out in applause, actually, very much hoping that they will come over and talk to them. And I think that is something that is happening at the moment. We're going to try and show you the picture of that. You will appreciate that I am trapped in this press pen and I can't move about. But that is something that's happening. They're going to go over and talk to them. So at the moment, the four of them, Harry, Meghan, the Prince and Princess of Wales, William and Kate, have gone across to talk to members of the public. They're just greeting them. You can see that the crowds are absolutely loving this moment. They were applauding a moment ago. There are lots and lots of people craning their necks to see what's going on and to catch a glimpse of them and to be a part of a moment of history, because a lot of people, as much as they're coming to pay their respects, they are also showing that they really want to be present in these moments of history. And this too will be seen as a really symbolic historical moment when a family that was experiencing a rift has come together to protect that institution of the monarchy and to show support for King Charles III. And we can see there members of the crowd have got their phones out. I don't know how many of those are actually going to be able to get very good pictures because they're sort of clambering over each other. But there is a real clamour to see these four individuals who are, of course, very popular members of the royal family. We know that there is a lot of interest in the younger members of the royal family. They are now going to have to step up. William, of course, is now first in line to the throne. He is the Prince of Wales. His father, as Prince of Wales, showed a lot of interests. He developed and cultivated many, many charities. We heard earlier about the Prince's Trust. It will be interesting to see what William now does with his new role. And we can see there that many members of the crowd are continuing to carry on, trying to catch a glimpse of them.
Yes, as you say, Fatima, as we see the prince and princess there with members of the public who've come to see them, and presumably Harry and Meghan doing the same somewhere else nearby, it remains to be seen exactly how the prince will define his new role. We've seen how King Charles has said how his life is going to change, how he will not be able to pursue interests in the same way as he had as the Prince of Wales. But this new couple are a different generation and they have different historic interests in terms of charity and causes that they pursue. But you sense that from the way the King has put them really very much at the forefront of his announcements, that their profile, their responsibilities are growing immensely and will continue to do that as they define exactly what their roles will be. There have been some briefings from people close to the Prince and Princess of Wales talking about how they will not feel at all bound by history, by the previous Princess of Wales, Diana, of course, or William's father, in terms of exactly how they pursued the roles, how they will be their own people, and how they will pursue their own paths. And you can see the Princess of Wales talking, especially to the children. Absolutely delighted crowds who were not expecting this. And there, Harry and Meghan doing the same and taking condolences and best wishes and flowers and handshakes. And these are very much the images that huge numbers of people in the general public have been wanting to see. And very much a symbol of the modernisation of the royal family. If you think back to what we've seen in the past and the quiet we've seen in the past, this is quite a change, quite a leap of how this new royal family will be conducting itself. And so another remarkable day draws to an end with very, very memorable pictures. We will have more tomorrow. Until then, that's Channel 4 News. Good evening.
God save the King.
God save the King.
Cheers for His Majesty the King. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
I swear by Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty King Charles.